For Comedy Hype News, I'm Tatiana LaJoy. Sometimes the most memorable characters in sitcoms aren't in the main cast or appear in every episode. Having a set of supporting and reoccurring characters in a series help build out the show's universe and provides them with more material to work with, giving them more depth in the process. The Jamie Foxx Show features a cast that rivaled any Black sitcom on the air at the time. Jamie Foxx is obviously the anchor of the show, but his chemistry on screen acting opposite Garcelle Beauvais and Christopher B. Duncan provided many laughs throughout. Legends with established names like Elia English and Garrett Morris added value and direction as well. Even with an all-star main cast, an argument can be made for the reoccurring characters that Jamie surrounded himself with. Curtis, Phil and Mouse, played by Chris Spencer, Alex Thomas, and Sully McCullough, respectively. These three were Jamie's co-workers who often enabled his antics and often made situations worse for him. Despite this, they always had Jamie's back and were willing to go to bat for him, no matter what. The character Mouse will always be recognized by his nasally voice and nerdy disposition, but the smiles he brought to audiences have left an imprint, even after all these years. Here's what happened to Mouse from The Jamie Foxx Show. Born in Los Angeles, California, but raised in Silicon Valley, Sully McCullough began comedy while attending UCLA at their comedy club. Students who wanted to be stand-up comedians would get together on campus, help each other with jokes, and put on shows in dorm rooms and perform for friends. In the process, they'd book one real comedian in order to build relationships in the industry. In a podcast interview with Neil Brennan and Masha Kasher, McCullough revealed that's how he met several comedians, including David Spade. Around 1989-1990, McCullough began performing at open mics at the Comedy Store. His early material consisted of impressions like Spike Lee and Woody Allen. Eventually, he made his way up the ladder and began working at other comedy clubs like the Improv and the Laugh Factory. One night in college, comedian Jerry Seinfeld performed at UCLA, and McCullough was one of the selected comedians to open for him. After the show, he was approached by Seinfeld's manager, who told him that he had a lot of talent and to give him a call. McCullough was only a junior in college at the time. While performing at the Improv Comedy Club in Irvine, California, McCullough was seen by casting agents from the then hit sitcom Married with Children, who brought him in for an audition. Before that, his only on-screen acting appearance was one episode of A Different World. However, McCullough would go uncredited for his appearance. Sully continued to guest star in several popular sitcoms throughout the 90s, which included Martin, In Living Color, and The Fresh Prince of Bel-Air. He also had a small role in the film, What's Love Got to Do with It? In 1996, McCullough stumbled upon one of the roles which he still gets recognized for to this day, Crazy Legs in the parody Don't Be a Menace to South Central While Drinking Your Juice in the Hood. In an interview with Dean Del Rey, McCullough revealed how his role in Don't Be a Menace came to be. In the film, McCullough portrayed Crazy Legs, whom he revealed was based off the man in the wheelchair in Boys in the Hood. Crazy Legs was a man who didn't see his condition as restricting. To prepare, McCullough visited hood parks where he would watch cookouts and how everyone interacted. For this role, he received some criticism, as some thought he was making fun of people in wheelchairs. McCullough was asked how long it took for them to write the movie. Now, although Sully isn't a credited writer on Don't Be a Menace, he said it took about a year to write. When the movie first came out, audiences weren't aware that this was a parody movie, thinking it's another hood film in a genre that was popular at the time. While working his way up in comedy, he was in the same comedy clubs as Sean Wayans, and the idea was to make a funny movie that made an impact. As stated before, McCullough had a relationship with the Wayans that preceded Don't Be a Menace and would extend well after. The Wayans Brothers, Seinfeld, and The Larry Sanders Show were some of the sitcoms McCullough guest starred in after appearing in Don't Be a Menace. In 2001, McCullough made his first guest appearance on The Jamie Foxx Show. He appeared as Jamie's grandson in a dream sequence as the character JJ in a third season episode. The following year, McCullough returned as a new character with no mention of his previous role. McCullough was in a total of 25 episodes of The Jamie Foxx Show, 24 of them playing his recognizable and lovable character Mouse. Mouse was a co-worker of Jamie's at Jingles 2000, along with Phil and Curtis, played by Alex Thomas and Chris Spencer, respectively. Mouse worked in the mailroom at Jingles for 8 years before he was promoted to a jingle writer by Jamie under his supervision. A loyal friend to Jamie brought out the best in Mouse, always delivered the laughs, making his on-screen contribution valuable. After the ending of The Jamie Foxx Show, McCullough continued to work with the Wayans family. In 2001, he reunited with them to lend his voice to a character in Scary Movie 2. After 2001, it appears as though Sully took a hiatus from performing in front of the camera and decided to focus on TV writing. In the interview, McCullough explained that some comedians would suggest that he write for other comedians. After his recurring role as Mouse on The Jamie Foxx Show, Foxx got offers to host various events, and he would bring McCullough along with him to write. In 2001, Foxx hosted the 2001 MTV Video Music Awards, which Sully was a co-writer on. Foxx brought him back when he hosted the 2009 BET Awards and even contributed writing a sketch on the Saturday Night Live when Foxx hosted in 2012. McCullough was also a writer for the 2005 American Music Awards and the 2012 Soul Train Awards. Both ceremonies were hosted by Cedric the Entertainer. In addition to contributing to award shows, McCullough has also made a living writing for late night shows. In 2005, he began writing for the short-lived Comedy Central series, Weekends at the DL, hosted by DL Hughley. The show was canceled after 28 episodes aired, and McCullough was a contributor the entire time the show was on the air. Sully also made history as the only black writer on The Tonight Show with Jay Leno, and he joined the staff in 2009, just as Leno was preparing to hand the show over to Conan O'Brien. The following year, in 2010, he began writing for Lopez Tonight. McCullough continues to write for late-night talk shows and various award shows, his most recent being the 2021 Primetime Emmy Awards, which he also hosted by Cedric. Show business and acting runs in Sully's family. His wife is a Hollywood manager who now manages her and Sully's children. Their daughter is an actress. When he wrote for the 2012 Nickelodeon Kids' Choice Awards, hosted by Will Smith, she hosted the orange carpet interviews for Access Hollywood. McCullough's son is a child model and actor who got his start in commercials. McCullough has realized his impact in television screens, and he said he gets recognized most for his roles in Don't Be a Menace and The Jamie Foxx Show. He remembered one incident at an airport in Houston where he was stopped by a woman who shouted at him and said, "Jamie Foxx left your ass," implying that Jamie had moved on and got famous from the show while he didn't. He laughed, recalling the occurrence. The 25 episodes he spent on The Jamie Foxx Show hadn't gotten out of that woman's mind, as Mouse's charm and likability left an impact on her and all of his other fans. Stay up to date with the latest news and comedy by subscribing here to our YouTube channel. Follow Comedy Hype across all social media and look out for original content on our new streaming service at comedyhype.com. For Comedy Hype News, I'm Tatiana LaJoy.